In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all the peoples.
For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods.
For all the gods of the peoples are worthless idols, but the Lord made the heavens.
Splendor and majesty are before him, strength and beauty are in his sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due to his name. Bring an offering and honor to his works.
Worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness. Tremble before him, all the earth.
Say among the nations, the Lord reigns. Yes, the world is established. It shall never be moved. He will judge the peoples effectively.
Let the heavens be glad, and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar, and all that fills it.
Let the field exult, and everything in it.
Then shall the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord, for he comes. For he comes to judge the earth.
He will judge the world in righteousness, and the peoples in his faithfulness.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Please be seated. Welcome to St. Paul's and this first offering in the 30th season of the Music at St. Paul's series. Featured this afternoon is sacred music composed by Mark Bender. We are assembled here to recognize Mark and his 47 years of service as a Lutheran elementary school teacher and minister of music, and to honor and thank God for his gifts to the church through Mark. The hymn concertato, Christ is Made the Sure Foundation, that began this service was commissioned by Emmanuel Evangelical Lutheran Church, Alexandria, Virginia, on the occasion of the congregation's 150th anniversary in 2020. Emmanuel's cantor, Stephanie McConan, selected this great hymn of the Christian Church. It is wed to Henry Purcell's noble tune, Westminster Abbey. Note, due to COVID restrictions, Emmanuel Church has postponed until June 2022 the anniversary celebration at which this hymn arrangement was to be first used. As a result of that delay, this afternoon, you participated in the first public singing of this setting. O Lord, I love the habitation of your house was written while Mark was serving as minister of music at Trinity Lutheran Church, Indianapolis, Indiana. In 1987, the congregation was preparing to install Reverend David Reed, her fourth pastor in her 112-year history. A short choral response was needed during the installation service. Mark selected a responsory text from the Office of Matins. The deadline for printing the worship folder was at hand, so he submitted the text. Then he wrote the musical setting. A bit risky? Yes, indeed. Around that time, a student gave him a plaque that read, "If it weren't for the last minute, a lot of things wouldn't get done."
Thank you.
In 1990, Trinity Lutheran Church and School, Manistee, Michigan, commissioned Mark to prepare a hymn concertato on the occasion of the 10th anniversary of Mark Kirchenberg, who was serving that congregation as teacher and director of parish music. Since no hymn suggestion was given, Mark chose, "I Will Sing My Maker's Praises." The text is by Paul Gerhardt, the greatest German Lutheran hymn writer of the 17th century. Johann Schopp's powerful tune carries the text well. The original setting was based on the text translation and tune in Lutheran worship. Today's setting is a revision of the former and represents the hymn as it appears in Lutheran's service book.
Thank you.
the end of the 2012 school year marked the retirement of three St. Louis Lutheran school choir directors. They were Carol Benninghoff, Sherry Bierwagen, and John Frank. In recognition of their dedication and long service to Lutheran elementary education and to school choirs in particular, Mark chose John Newton's text, "How Sweet the Name of Jesus Sounds," and composed an original tune. To honor these three retired directors, this piece was sung by the Lutheran School's Honors Choir at its fall 2012 concert at Lutheran High School South. John G. Miller's retirement in 2008 brought to a close his formal service as a Lutheran school teacher and director of parish music. In thanksgiving to God for the life of this servant, the senior choir of Holy Cross Lutheran Church, Fort Wayne, Indiana, commissioned Mark to prepare a hymn concertato for the retirement festival service. Though they were a generation apart in age, John Miller and Mark were longtime friends and colleagues in church music. Mark chose the text, "So Much to Sing About," by LCMS hymn writer Yaroslav J. Vida. Besides the text's mention of singing and praise, the reference in stanza 3 to one's age of 70 years seemed particularly appropriate for the occasion. Mark composed an original and somewhat daring tune to carry the text. A note about the tune name, Miller 2. Cheryl Miller Ferry was serving as St. Paul's music ministry assistant at that time. Mark showed her the tune. She made several helpful suggestions to improve it. To recognize her assistance and the retiree, Mark named the tune Miller. However, he later discovered that Miller was one name given to a tune associated with the text, Away in a Manger. Thus the tune's name, Miller 2.
Thank you.
is in the closing days of the calendar year, following Christmas Eve and Christmas Day services, that most prepared church musicians may take a breath. However, it was at that time, in 1983, when Mark realized that Trinity's adult choir needed a choral piece for the approaching Epiphany Day service. He chose the responsory text for the season of Epiphany. What was missing was a musical arrangement that could be learned by the choir when the singers arrived 30 minutes prior to the first service that day. The result was, "Arise, shine, for your light has come." The singing of the piece during the second service that day was probably a bit more confident, since the choir had had a dress rehearsal in the earlier service. Over the years, other choirs have sung this little piece during the season of Epiphany. Several choir directors have told Mark that this is their choir's standby winter storm anthem in case weather conditions on a Sunday morning limit choral forces that day. The next hymn, Concertato, is the only one on this program not composed by Mark Bender. At the direction of cantor Matthew Gerhardt, Music at St. Paul's commissioned Milwaukee composer Benjamin Cully to arrange a hymn in honor of Mark's years of service and his retirement. In consultation with Peter Reske of Concordia Publishing House, the hymn "Let Us Ever Walk with Jesus" was chosen. This text and tune have long enjoyed frequent usage in LCMS congregations, particularly in confirmation services. Once again this afternoon, you are participating in the world premiere of a new composition. During the summer of 2000, David Johnson of Concordia Publishing House invited several composers to each write a piece to honor teacher and church music colleague, Reverend Henry V. Gehrke, on the occasion of his 30th anniversary in the ministry. Mark accepted the invitation and combined two things he knew about Henry. One was Henry's deep appreciation of the writings and hymns of Martin H. Fransman. The poem, "Thee, Lord, Would I Serve," seemed fitting at that milestone in his friend's life. The other was Henry's love of the Martin Schalling hymn, "Lord, Thee I Love with All My Heart," combined with the tune "Herzlich Lieb." Mark set the Fransman text to original music. Toward the end of the piece, the Schalling hymn is brought to mind by quoting only two of its musical phrases. The first phrase recalls the text, "Lord, let at last thine angels come." The second phrase recalls the words, "And I will praise thee without end." The hymn concertato that closes this festival was commissioned by Lutheran Church of the Resurrection, Sunset Hills, Missouri, on the occasion of her 50th anniversary in 2006. John Frank was serving as music director and suggested the new hymn, Text Verification, by LCMS pastor Stephen Starkey, based on the canticle, the Te Deum. In Lutheran service book, the text is wed to Gustav Holst's stirring tune, Thaxted. The marriage of that text and tune is the hymn, "We Praise You and Acknowledge You, O God," which is being widely used in the church today. This setting has been used at weddings, high school youth services, and for other occasions. Near the beginning of this service, the Old Testament writer of Psalm 96 invited us to sing to the Lord, bless his name, tell of his salvation from day to day. That salvation is ours through Jesus Christ, the Son of God. To save all people from their sins, he suffered, died on the cross, and rose again to life. Christ is the world's Redeemer. That is the salvation we proclaim. There is still so much to sing about.
Please stand for prayer.
We pray. Everlasting Father, source of every blessing, mercifully direct and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that we may complete the works you have prepared for us to do. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
God of majesty, whom saints and angels delight to worship in heaven, be with your servants who make art and music for your people, that with joy we may on earth may glimpse your beauty. Bring us to the fulfillment of that hope of perfection that will be ours as we stand before your unveiled glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom come all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And